Good morning. Hello. Hi. Happy Wednesday to you. This is the last Wednesday of the month of September. What? Can you believe it? It's almost October. Whoa. September just flew by. That's right. Well, today is Wednesday, which means we get to do some church together, which means we're going to sing to Jesus, we're going to talk to Jesus, and we're going to learn some more about Jesus. And after this video, you and your parents are going to work together to do a couple of activities that help you remember what we talked about. I mean, how cool is that? Completely cool, right? All right, before we get started, we need to get a little loosened up. So stand up on your feet. Stretch up tall, touch your belly, touch your back, touch your elbows, touch your nose, touch your cheeks, touch your chin, touch your forehead, touch your knees, touch your toes. Woo! That was quick. All right, roll your shoulders. Show me 5 fingers. Show me 10 fingers. Show me 12 fingers. Can't do that, can I? I can go 1, 2, 12. Show me a happy face. Show me a mad face. Show me a sad. Show me a scary face. Show me a sleepy face. And show me one more, a silly face. Good job. All right, now we need to talk to Jesus. What's it called when we talk to him? Yes, prayer. And you can do it no matter how old you are, no matter where you are, no matter what you want to say to him. God always hears us when we talk to him. So let's get our prayer hands out. We're gonna talk to Jesus, ask him to help us pay really good attention during our Bible story so we can remember it really well, right? All right, close your eyes. Say, dear Jesus, I love you. Help me to listen to my Bible story and to remember it. I love you, Jesus. It's in your name that we pray, amen. We're gonna sing about how there's one person that helps us make every move we make. Yeah, that's right. It's God. So help me out here, all right? every move we make, Jesus helps us. Isn't that so cool? Okay, we're gonna sing one more song. This song is about how our God is so big, so strong, so mighty. There's nothing he can't do. Yeah, and in our Bible story in a few minutes, we're gonna see that God does something incredible. So, let's sing about this awesome, incredible, so big, so mighty, nothing he can't do, God. Yeah, let's do this. Ready? Say, my God is so big.
My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
For you.
My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. And the mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Alright, let's do it again.
My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
For you.
My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
For you.
My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
For you.
The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Continue to learn our story about Joseph. So have a seat, open up your eyes, open up your ears, zip your lip, and let's learn the next part of Joseph's story.
Who? Who? You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning.
Strawberries for Kai, and gummy worms for Lucy. Oh, hello there. Welcome to the clubhouse. It's me, Manny, and I'm so happy to see you today. So I'm making sure we have all the things we need for everyone to follow their ice cream sundae plans. Let's see. Kai wants vanilla ice cream. Check. Lucy wants chocolate ice cream. Check. Now let's check our toppings. Kai wants whipped cream. Check. And strawberries. Check. Lucy wants gummy worms. Check. I want chocolate syrup. Oh, and sprinkles. Lots of sprinkles. Wow, I think we have everything we need for everyone to follow their ice cream sundae plans. And each plan is different.
Hoo, hoo.
Hey, it's Ollie.
Hello, Manny. Hoo, hoo. Following some party plans, are you?
Hi, Ollie, I sure am. Everybody has a different plan for their ice cream sundaes.
You have many different plans. It's true. I have a story about the best plan for you. Just listen to this story. Just follow me through. Hoo, hoo.
Follow me through. Follow me through, hoo. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Ready? And go! Oh, hi, friends. I'm Carrie the dog walker, and this is my best dog, Stormy Jane, and her friends, Goldie and Barkley. We're celebrating Ice Cream Sundae Month with a doggy sundae party. I think they like them. We're also celebrating because we have been learning about God's plan for Joseph, and today we get to hear the last part of his story, and it is awesome. Do you know who this is? Yep, it's Joseph. He always trusted in God's plan. And these are Joseph's 11 brothers, who got super mad and jealous when their dad gave Joseph a special coat and didn't give them one. So they stole the coat, threw Joseph in a hole, and sent him with people who took him far away from home where he was thrown in jail. Then Joseph was taken out of jail, helped the Pharaoh learn about his dreams, and got put in charge of giving hungry people food. Wow, three cheers for God's plan. God's plan is awesome. Hip, hip, hooray. Can you say that with me? Ready? Hip, hip, hooray. One more time. Hip, hip, hooray. No matter how hard it was, Joseph knew that God loved him, that God was always with him, and that he could trust God's plan. But that's not the end of the story. There is more to God's plan. Remember Joseph's brothers? Well, now, back at home, wait a minute. Stormy Jane, you're not a brother in this story. Get out of there, silly dog. That's better. Okay, so back at home, the brothers were super hungry and had no food. And guess where they had to go to get food? You got it. They had to go see Joseph because he was in charge of all the food. But they didn't know Joseph was in charge. Well, one day, Joseph was at the palace when his brothers came looking for food. Joseph was so surprised to see them. Show me your surprise face. That's good. Joseph had a choice to make. Choice one, he could forgive his brothers and give them food to eat. Or choice two, he could just send them away hungry. What do you think God wanted Joseph to do? Choice one, you're right. That's exactly what Joseph did. Joseph forgave his brothers and gave them food to eat. He even gave them a hug and was happy to see them. It was the best ending to the story because Joseph followed God's plan. I love how Joseph followed God's plan. I want to follow God's plan, and you can too. God's plan is the best plan. Oh, hey, Ollie. Ollie, tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me. Who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time. Bye.
So there's your story. It's all true. God has the best plan of all for me and for you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow, what a great story. Joseph's life really shows us how God's plan is always the best plan. God loves us so much and always has the best plans for us. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! God's plan is always the best plan. But we have some great plans for our ice cream sundae party too. Can't wait for the party to start. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
So in our Bible story today, we continue to learn about Joseph, right? He has had some hard times in his life. Yeah, and some things that happened to him that weren't very fair, weren't very nice. Well, at this point, remember, Joseph was in charge of all the food for the whole land. And his brothers were so hungry. They had to come to Joseph to ask for food. But they didn't know that Joseph was in charge. And when he saw them, he was so surprised. Now Joseph had a choice to make. He could either forgive his brothers and give them some food to eat, or he could not forgive them and not give them food to eat. Joseph forgave his brothers and even gave them food so that they could no longer have to be hungry. He even gave them hugs and told them who he was and how excited he was to see them. It was such a cool ending to a story that had a lot of ups and downs, right? Joseph had hard times and his brothers had treated him really, really badly. So in some ways, you would think it would almost be fair for him to be mean back to the brothers. But Joseph knew that God had a plan and he trusted God's plan. So he forgave his brothers and gave them food. I love how Joseph followed God's plan. That's what I want to do. I want to follow God's plan. What about you? Do you want to follow God's plan? Yeah, we should all strive to follow the plan that God has for us. Now, we've been learning a verse these last few weeks. This is the last time with this verse, so let's say it all together. Ready? Stand up tall. Say, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord." Jeremiah 29:11. Let's try it again. "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord." Jeremiah 29:11. Okay, listen. There are just two super important things that I need to tell you before we finish out today. The first and most important is that this Sunday, October 4th, 3 days from now, this Sunday, yes, we have Leave It Better Day. Leave It Better Day is something that we've done for a few years here at the church. It's when everyone divides up and goes all over the community and does different service projects to help people. And there is a huge variety of things to do. This year, we've made sure to keep into account that some people won't feel comfortable going into places or going to help with a large group of people. So there is a lot of projects that can even be done from your house. Your house! You know, where you live 7 days a week, surely you can do a project in your own house. Yes, you need to have your mom and dad go to leaveitbetterws.com. Leaveitbetterws.com. When you get to that page, you can scroll down and there's a list of all the projects and what each project involves. There are just a few that you have to be a certain age for. So for those, you wouldn't be able to participate, but that's only a couple of them. The rest of them are wide open to everyone. And when I say everyone, I mean everyone. Yeah, even you. Some are outside, some are inside, some are at the church, and some are in the community, and some can be done from your house. So there is no excuse. We need every one of you to pitch in and help us leave it better. Now, there's one other thing you need to do, and that's your activities. Remember, church is not something we watch, it's something that we do. So have your mom or dad click on the link below the video, download the activity sheet, and work together to complete the two simple activities. You got it? Don't forget it, okay? That's all for today. Do your activities, sign up for Leave It Better. I love you guys.